Hello and welcome to Standard & Poor's Credit Matters TV. I'm Giuseppina Martelli, an Associate Director in the ABS team at Standard & Poor's, and today I'm joined by my colleague Giovanni Inglisa, also in the ABS team. Welcome, Giovanni.
Hello.
Today we are discussing about the performance of Italian ABS lease transactions during the first semester of 2013. Giovanni, Standard & Poor's recently published its Italian ABS Lease Index report. Can you give us some insights into the main trends for this asset class?
Sure. Standard & Poor's quarterly publishes an index that aims to track the performance of the collateral that has been securitized in Italian leasing transactions. The index is a dynamic index as it measures both delinquencies and periodic defaults, so leasing receivables that each quarter are classified into default. If you take a look at the chart that you're seeing on the screen now, you can see that delinquencies have been broadly stable since the beginning of 2011, while defaults have picked up, reaching a record high of 1.8% in Q4 2012. So that means basically that the borrowers, rather than going back to current, they stay delinquent and then they default. In 2013, you can see that in Q1 and Q2, periodic defaults decreased slightly to 1.4 and 1.2% in respectively in Q1 and Q2 2013. However, these figures are still very high, especially if you compare them with 2009, when Italy experienced a severe recession. Still, the periodic defaults were much lower, around 0.8 to 0.9% every quarter.
Okay, so I understand that even if the performance did not deteriorate, it remains still quite weak. Can you please tell us if this weak performance had any impact on the ratings of these transactions?
Yeah, it had a negative impact because in Q1 and Q2 2013, we reviewed the 5 transactions and in all of them, we increased the base case assumption. So the result of this increase was the downgrade of mezzanine and junior tranches. On the other hand, senior tranches were able to withstand the higher stress and still they were able to keep their rating. These downgrades are basically the consequence of the prolonged recession that Italy is experiencing. In 2012, the GDP dropped by 2.5% and our economic forecasts hint at a minus 1.8% GDP drop for 2013.
We discussed about the past. What about the future? What is Standard & Poor's outlook for the next months? Do you expect more downgrades?
We don't expect this collateral performance to trigger a significant number of negative rating action, thanks to the large credit enhancement that is embedded in our transactions. There are for sure two positive developments which are worth underlining. One of them is the fact that the Italian Banking Association has extended the payment holiday scheme, and the other one is the fact that the government has approved a decree which basically will accelerate the payments due from the public administration to the private companies. One negative aspect that we acknowledge is the fact that the Italian export performance is quite weak. So given the fact that many of these leases have been granted to SMEs, and given the fact that in Italy many SMEs are exporters, a weak performance of Italian export could in turn have a negative effect on the portfolios which back our transactions. But overall, I would say that our outlook for 2013, for the next 6 months, is stable.
Okay, thank you, Giovanni, for your insights, and thank you for watching Credit Matters TV.